daughters and their spouses, and I would like to join Nick and Gail and their sons, including you, and their spouse into our loving family.
Sam, you've really been an amazing little sister and truly grown into a beautiful, successful, reliable, and independent woman. Take each day and cherish your time together. Love one another and stand together. Take time to talk to one another. Put your love and family first, your job and hobbies second, and love each other above all else.
Being his older brother, I have been able to see him progress throughout his entire life. And he is the man. That's pretty much all I can say. And Sam, you're super lucky. I knew whoever married my little brother was going to get the man. So your family, very fortunate to have Trent in it. And I think we're pretty fortunate to have you as well.
Well, tomorrow's the L House 44 wedding. It was so sweet that they decided to be married on our And I'm thinking, no, what's the trench plan? Is he wanting me to help him remember?
Yeah.
Or does he think I'm getting so old and senile, he needs to help me remember? I'm just trying to figure this all out. So a couple of weeks ago, Mike and Olivia came down, and they were at our house for Labor Day. And Mike and I are sitting out in the patio having a drink, and I said, "Hey, Mike, I said, what about this October wedding? Why am I having an October?" "Oh, I know the answer." He says, "Well, the Spick family, the minute the Michigan Spick schedule came out, we realized that October the 1st was a walkover. It's the easiest game on the schedule. So that's going to be the day." Of course, tomorrow they're playing Indiana. So now you know the rest. So, what I'd like to say right now, if you have a glass, raise it, and let's toast my son Trent and the future Samantha Dark.
I got you, I got everything, I got you. With
in your love.
Welcome. You may be seated. We've come together on this beautiful afternoon as the family and friends of Trent and Samantha to celebrate this commitment of love as they join together their hearts and lives in marriage. And on their behalf, I would like to express their deep appreciation for your attendance and certainly for the love and support and encouragement that you've shown by being here. This is indeed an extraordinary day in their lives, and they hope that you would truly enjoy this moment. And then before we continue, the bride and groom have requested that we take a special moment to remember those family members who are no longer with us and are very much missed. Although we wish these dear loved ones could be here with us today, we do celebrate that they're with us in spirit, and we want to honor the wonderful legacies they have left. So certainly a significant part of the ceremony today is dedicated to them. This is a day of some very important questions. The first of those questions is this: who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother.
Trent, do you take this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together in God's grace and the holy bond of marriage? The winds of change are upon us. Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, remain faithful to her so long as you both shall live? Samantha, do you take this man to be your wedded husband, to live together in God's grace and the holy bond of marriage? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, remain faithful to him so long as you both shall live? Please repeat after me the vows you have chosen. Shouldn't have that beautiful veil. I, Trent, take you, Samantha.
I, Trent, take you, Samantha.
To be my wife.
Be my wife.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
My faithful partner.
Faithful partner.
And my love from this day forward.
My love from this day forward.
In the presence of God, our family, and friends.
In the presence of God, family, and our friends.
I offer you my solemn vow.
I offer you my solemn vow.
To be your faithful partner.
Your faithful partner.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and in health.
In good times and in bad.
Good times and bad.
And in joy as well as in sorrow.
And in joy as well as in sorrow.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
To support you in your goals.
To support you in your goals.
To honor and respect you.
Respect you.
To laugh with you and cry with you.
To laugh with you and cry with you.
And to cherish you.
And to cherish you.
All the days of our lives.
All the days of our lives.
Samantha, please also repeat after me. I, Samantha, take you, Trent.
I, Samantha, take you, Trent.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
My faithful partner.
My faithful partner.
And my love from this day forward.
My love from this day forward.
In the presence of God, our family, and friends.
In presence of God, our family, and friends.
I offer you my solemn vow.
I offer you my solemn vow.
To be your faithful partner.
To be your faithful partner.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
And in joy as well as in sorrow.
And in joy as well as sorrow.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
To support you in your goals.
To support you in your goals.
To honor and respect you.
To honor and respect you.
To laugh with you and cry with you.
To laugh with you and cry with you.
And to cherish you.
And to cherish you.
All the days of our lives.
All the days of our lives.
And now the bride and groom have chosen to exchange rings as symbols of their love. Thank you. These eagerly sought-after rings are very appropriate symbols of your union. In fact, you'll find they serve as a great metaphor for marriage. Because they're made of precious metal, they are pure, just as your love and faithfulness and dedication to each other must always be. And as circles, they have no ending, just as your spoken promises to each other today or for the rest of your lives. So Trent, please place this ring on Samantha's finger. please repeat after me. Samantha with this ring.
Samantha with this ring.
I choose you as my wife.
I choose you as my wife.
I give you my name.
I give you my name.
And all that I am.
All that I am.
I will love you and care for you.
I will love for you and care for you.
With all the strength that God gives.
All the strength that God gives.
Samantha, you can place this ring on Trent's finger. And kindly repeat after me. Trent with this ring.
Trent with this ring.
I choose you as my husband.
I choose you as my husband.
I give you myself.
I give you myself.
And all that I am.
And all that I am.
I will love you and care for you.
I will love you and care for you.
With all the strength that God gives.
With all the strength that God gives.
Well, now as we prepare to conclude and offer a final word of encouragement to this couple, you really all are a part of their extended family, every one of you. And so Trent and Samantha, as you are looking out at your friends and loved ones, they're the ones who will be there for you through life's various seasons to offer you their encouragement and support and to do everything that they can to help you succeed. So we're all committed to walking alongside you. And as you both prepare to leave this place and begin this wonderful journey called marriage, may the sun shine upon you and brighten your future. May each day bring with it more joy and optimism than the last. And then when you experience the inevitable challenges and difficulties of marriage, and they will be there, our hope and prayer for you is that you would actually grow closer together through those opportunities because of the grace and forgiveness that you lavish upon each other. Most important of all, never stop being best friends. You are soulmates, your hearts are now joined together as one, so may your love for each other be pure and eternal. And now for as much as you, Trent, and you, Samantha, have consented to holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God in this company, and thereto have given and pledged your love each to the other, according to the privileges given to me by the state of California, it really is my privilege to pronounce you husband and wife. What God has joined together, let no one separate. Woo! Take one final moment and look back out at your friends and family, some of whom I'm sure have traveled great distances to be here today. You might be asking yourself, why did they really make such an effort to be here today? Well, Trent, I'll tell you why. They all came here today because they want you to show them the proper way to kiss a new bride. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is very much my pleasure to present to you for the very first time Mr. and Mrs. Trent and Samantha Dark. Woo!
I loved you since the very first day when I caught you looking my way. I smiled and just knew it. And up until you came along, no one ever heard my song. Now it's climbing with a bullet. It's nice to have someone so honestly devoted. But when it's said and done, girl, I hope you know that traveling, the singing, don't mean nothing without you. And the fast cars, the guitars, they are all just second to this life, this love that you and I have been building up so high. It's never gonna touch the sky without you.
Talk to me,
girl. Talk to me, girl.